In 2016, the global lifetime risk of stroke from the age of 20 year onwards was approximately 25% among men and women.
What we know till now is that there is a certain susceptibility of human beings to get a stroke, which is a genetic susceptibility, which we are not understanding completely as of now. And that genetic susceptibility interacts with the environmental influences. And everybody knows the environmental influences. It's diabetes, it's hypertension, it's cigarette smoking, it's cholesterol, it's inactivity. Fabry's disease is again because of a genetic mutation in which there's a deficiency of an enzyme. And because of the deficiency of that enzyme, there is accumulation of a compound called trihexoceramide in blood vessels, tissues, and organs.
If you look at global burden of disease, it accounts for 5.5 million deaths. It accounted for in 2016. In India, we estimate we see about 1.6 million cases per year.
So, emerging trend of IVTPA since 2002, we have had noticed that there is a boom in the thrombolysis, be it elderly or the less than 65 years old, as they had a basic project that studied more than 5,000 patients. And we have the data that says the TPA use have steadily increased from 2% to 11% as the graph demonstrates over a period of last 10 years.
Thrombolysis in acute MI is always been a bit of a problem. And even not only is a problem of the treatment, there has been a conflict even with the guidelines. So the guidelines which have been evolving, and the previous guidelines kind of prevented us from treating at a certain time limit.
Many patients of stroke will always be having some other concomitant atherosclerotic process involving the cardiovascular system or peripheral vascular system or even the gastrointestinal vasculature, and they will be on antiplatelets.
Whenever they gave the thrombolysis, they found that those patients who gave the thrombolysis had probably did a marginally better. Their zero MRS was a little better than the patients who no thrombolysis was given, but overall the p-value was not significant.
If the patient was above the age of 80 years, the core has to be less than 21 cc with the NHS of more than 10, more than or equal to 10. And if it's less than 80, then depending on the NHS severity, the core changes. And then the patients undergo randomization.
Even if you get a small benefit by giving TPA, there's also an increased risk of hemorrhage. You do that bargain. You take the bargain of ICH at the cost of some benefit.
Neurocystic sarcosis in any stage can present as a stroke mimic. It is not uncommon that patients with NCC get mistaken as stroke.